गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास 8, दिस इज योर पार्ट 6 वीडियो फ्रॉम एक्सरसाइज 13.4, दैट इज बेसिक्स ऑफ क्वाड्रिलेटरल. एंड टुडे वी स्टार्ट फ्रॉम क्वेश्चन नंबर 1. ओके, व्हाट द क्वेश्चन नंबर 1? फाइंड द लेंथ ऑफ द डायगोनल ऑफ रेक्टेंगल. नंबर 1, फाइंड द लेंथ ऑफ द डायगोनल ऑफ अ रेक्टेंगल हुज ब्रेथ एंड लेंथ आर 8 सेंटीमीटर एंड 15 सेंटीमीटर रिस्पेक्टिवली. फाइंड द लेंथ ऑफ द डायगोनल. ओके, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल फाइंड द लेंथ ऑफ अ डायगोनल ऑफ अ रेक्टेंगल. दिस इज योर रेक्टेंगल पोर्शन. We know the features of rectangle. Opposite sides are equal. Each angle contain 90 degree. Okay. The length. This is your diagonal portion. So A, B, C, D. Breadth and length are given. Breadth is 15 and length is 8. So if AB is 8 centimeter, this is also 8 centimeter because we know that opposite sides are equal. If BC is 15 centimeter, that means AD is also 15 centimeter. Find the length of the diagonal DB. Okay. So in triangle DAB, you see 90 is here because we know that each angle of our rectangle is 90 degree. Okay. But here is triangle is formation. We know that whenever right angle triangle, the opposite of 90 is called hypotenuse by Pythagoras theorem. So by Pythagoras theorem, we know that hypotenuse square is equals to height square plus base square. So 90 opposite, always we know that hypotenuse. So hypotenuse in place, we write down DB square height. This is your height, that is AD square plus base portion, this is, that is AB square. Okay, so DB square equals to AD, that is 15 square plus 8 square, 225. 15 square is 15 into 15, that is 225. 8 into 8, that is 64 DB square. So therefore DB equals to root under 225 plus 64, that is 289, that is 17 centimeter. So the length of the diagonal is 17 centimeter. Done. Note. Question number 3. The length of the diagonal of a rhombus are 24 centimeter and 10 centimeter. Find out the length of all its sides. So question is, the length, the diagonal of a rhombus are 24 and 10 centimeters. Suppose this is a rhombus portion. This diagonal is 24 and this one is 10 centimeter. Clear? So A, B, C, D. That means BD equals to 24 centimeter and AC is 10 centimeter given. Find the length of all sides. The basic most important thing, we know that the length of all sides of rhombus are equal because in previous class we learned the features of the rhombus. Okay. And one more important features, that the length of the diagonal of the rhombus are bisect and intersect. Bisect means, suppose they are bisect at 0. So the bisect means equally divided. So this AC is 10. That means AO equals to OC. This 10 is divided in two equal parts. That is, was 10 divided by 2, it's 5 centimeter. Clear? and the BD is 24, so this is also bisected. So BO equals to OD equals to 24 upon 2, that is 12 centimeter, because we know that the length of the diagonal, the length of the diagonal of a rhombus are bisect and intersect at 90 degree. What do you mean by intersect? Whenever this angle bisect, it also intersect, that means it create 90 degree. Here is 90 degree. Done. So you check it, the in triangle AOB we know that this is 90 degree and opposite of 90 degree is always hypotenuse. So by Pythagoras theorem we know that hypotenuse square is equals to height square plus base square. So hypotenuse is AB, that is AB square height, take this one is height, that is AO square, and base, take one, this one is base, that is OB square. So you see AO, AO is value is 5 square and OB is 12 square. So AB equals, AB square equals to 5, that is 5 square is 25 and 12 square is 144. So AB square equals to 169. Therefore AB equals to root under 169, that is 13 centimeter. That means this portion is 13. If this portion is 13 centimeter, that means this one is also 13. This one is also 13 and this one is also 13. So therefore AB equals to BC equals to CD equals to DA equals to 13 centimeter, because we know that all sides of a rhombus are equal. Okay, note. Question number 5. Find the length of a side of a rhombus whose perimeter is 60 centimeter. Find the length of a side whose perimeter is 60 centimeter. Suppose this is your this is your rhombus, that is A, B, C, D. A, B, C, D is a rhombus, okay. Perimeter, first of all we take in the length of side. Let the length of a side of a rhombus be X centimeter. That means this one is X, this one is S, this one is X, this one is X. Done, na? So we know that the perimeter formula, perimeter equals to sum of all sides. We know that. So here we taken, let length of AB, let the length of AB of room, let the length of AB be X centimeter. So when AB is X, that means BC is also X, CD is also X and DA is also X, because we know that all sides of a rhombus are equal. So perimeter is given 60 and sum of all sides, that is X plus X plus X. So that is 60 equals to 4X, therefore X equals to 60 by 4, that is 15 centimeter. So the one side of a rhombus is 15 centimeter. Okay, note. Now turn for question number 7. If the length of one side of rhombus is equal to the length of one diagonal, find the angle of rhombus. Okay, you see, if the length of one side of rhombus is equals to the length of one diagonal, find the angle of the rhombus. This question is different. Suppose this is your rhombus portion, that is A, B, C, D, and take this is diagonal BD. Okay, what the question? If the length of one side of rhombus is equal to the length of diagonal, so let length of AB, that means this one, is x centimeter. That means diagonal is also what? X centimeter, because clearly mentioned length of one side is equals to the diagonal. That means this one is also x. So therefore AB is equals to DB is equals to x centimeter given. Okay, now the point is what? We know that very well. If okay, take this portion is taken, this is also diagonal length, if the length of one side rhombus is equal to the length, what the question is, equal to the length, you see, is equal to the length of one diagonal. So that means what? In this triangle, this is equal. Remove this portion clearly. Okay, this one is x. Clear? We know that rhombus also contain the features of the parallelogram. That means this angle is equals to this one. Let angle D be 2x. This portion is 2x. When the diagonals go, is bisect the also the angle. We know that the length of the diagonal bisect the diagonal. The diagonals bisect each other and the diagonals bisect the angle also. Okay. So that means angle ADB equals to angle ADB and angle DAB. Sorry. BDA. Again I repeat. Only given these two sides are equal. Clear? We taken angle DB 2x and this one divided into x into x, or taken anything now y. Okay, let y, because we taken side as x. Okay, so this angle is 2y. So that means this portion divided yy, because we know that diagonals of the rhombus bisect the angles. So here we written diagonals of a rhombus bisect the angle. Clear? That means this one yy. Okay, we know that the rhombus also contain the features of a parallelogram. If this one is y, this one is also y. So you see z figure is drawn here, z, and we know that alternate interior angles are equal. So this angle equals to this one, that means angle CDB equals to angle DBA equals to y. That means this portion is equals to this portion. It's called alternate interior angles are equal. Okay, and question clearly given that these two sides are equal, the length of the rhombus and the diagonal of the rhombus are equal, and we know that when these two sides are equal, we know that when two sides are equal is called isosceles triangle. And we know that the features of the isosceles triangle, what? If two sides of a triangle are equal, then angle opposite to them are also equal. That means if two sides are equal, if this one is y, this one is also y, we write down angle B DA equals to angle DAB equals to Y, because when two sides of a triangle are equal, then angle opposite to them are equal. Opposite to them are equal. So we got it. What? This one is Y. Okay. Rhombus also contain the features of parallelogram. If this one is equal, that means this one is also Y. So you see opposite sides, that means angle A equals to angle C is Y, and angle D equals to angle B, that is 2Y. If this one is 2Y, this one is also 2Y. Okay, so opposite angles are equal. We know that rhombus also contain the features of a parallelogram, and additional features is that in parallelogram we know that opposite sides are equal, but additional feature of a rhombus is what? The all sides of rhombus are equals. Okay, so angle A plus angle B plus angle C plus angle D equals to 360. We know that sum of interior angle of a quadrilateral is 360. So A is Y, B is 2Y, C is Y, and D is 2Y equals to 360. Y, 2Y, 3Y, 4Y, 6Y, that is 6Y equals to 360. Therefore, Y equals to 360 by 6, that is 60 degree. So Y is 60 degree. So that means what? Angle A equals to angle C equals to 60 degree. And angle D equals to angle B is 2Y. So 2 in place of Y, we write down 60, that is 120 degree. So AC is 60 degree and DB is 120 degree. Okay, note.